This is lecture 3 of protoplast fusion. Now what we do, we mix protoplast of parents in 1:1 proportion. Centrifuge the mixture at 50 g for 3 to 5 minutes. So we have to mix protoplast. This protoplast when we isolate, then we have to mix them in 1:1 proportion and then centrifuge the mixture for 3 to 5 minutes. Then we remove the supernatant and add the fusion mixture. 2 ml of fusion mixture, that is 50 millimolar glycine NaOH buffer, 50 millimolar calcium chloride and 400 millimolar mannitol at pH 10.5. Now pellet the protoplast, then we again go for centrifugation, which result in the formation of pellet. Now place the centrifugation tube in water bath at 37 degrees Celsius for 10 to 30 minutes. Then we go for the incubation at 37 degrees Celsius. Now next step is to replace the fusion mixture by washing medium, that is 100 millimolar mannitol, 50 millimolar calcium chloride, and leave it for the 30 minutes. Then we wash it twice and suspend the protoplast in culture medium. So in this way, this is a protocol for the fusion of protoplasts. So here we use high concentration of mannitol, high pH, high calcium chloride concentration for the fusion of protoplast from two different species. Now there is one more chemical which is known as polyethylene glycol. So it is a polymer, and this polyethylene glycol can be successfully used for the germination of protoplast, for the fusion of protoplast. So PEG reported to cause alteration in the membrane structure. So now it alters the plasma membrane structure and aggregation of intramembrane proteins and glycoproteins. So protein-free lipid bilayer region appears in the plasma membrane, and whole process takes about 3 to 10 hours. So somehow it agglutinates the proteins and other glycoproteins in the plasma membrane, and protein-free lipid bilayer region appears in the plasma membrane. So this protein-free bilayer is usually where the fusion actually occurs. So two protoplasts, they have protein-free bilayer, they fuse with each other. So now in PEG, frequency of heterokaryon formation is high. It has very low toxicity. So these are the benefits. There is a high frequency of binucleate heterokaryon formation. And 2 to 3 protoplasts can be fused at a time. So there is a diagram. We can see that this is resistant leaf protoplast and cell culture protoplast. We brought them fusion using PEG and high calcium ion concentration. Then we have different, in some cases we get hybrid, in some cases we does not get any kind of hybrid. So this is whole about a PEG method. Now which factors affect this PEG fusion? The fusion is enhanced by enriching the PEG solution with calcium ion. As usual, calcium ion play a vital role in fusion of protoplast. Then dilution of PEG should be gradual. Prolonged incubation with PEG reduces heterokaryon formation, so the duration should be 10 to 30 minutes, not more than that. Protoplast from young leaves and fast growing calli gives better regions. So it is mentioned that if we have a callus culture of established protoplast, and if we have young leaves, then we'll have a better result of protoplast fusion, and 4 to 5% protoplast suspension gives high frequency. There are other chemicals such as poly L ornithine, poly D lysine, protamine sulfate, glycerol, DMSO. Then there is next method, electrofusion. In electrofusion, it utilizes electricity, or it utilizes low voltage non-uniform alternating current, that is AC current pulse. So here we are giving a pulse of electric current, alternating current, which is of low voltage. There are two types. During the high voltage is a few seconds, and voltage ranges from 500 to 1000 volt per centimeter. High voltage creates transient disturbance in the plasma membrane, and equipment used is an electrophorator. It is first used by Zimmermann. So it is also called as Zimmermann electrofusion system. Please note that Zimmermann is a very important scientist, and there might be a question on Zimmermann electrofusion system. Now if we look at this diagram, here glass capillary or electrodes are used. So there is a tonoplast layer. There is a cytoplasm, there is a vacuole. In this case, inside vacuole we are fusing a calcium ion. So electroimpulse insertion method is what we have described here. okay, and this is the equipment we called it as an electroporator. Now once we have generated, now till now what we have done, we have generated a protoplast and we have fused that protoplast. Now the next method is to select hybrids. So the visual selection method or fluorescent labels can be used, okay, just like octadecanyl aminofluorescein, octadecanyl palamine B, fluorescein diacetate, okay, then there is a rhodamine. So these are the dyes that has been used. Then there is a nutritional selection, DNA analysis, drug sensitivity and resistance. So these are the few methods. Now in my lecture of protoplast fusion, I have already discussed you the PPT and I have already given you the theoretical notes for these topics, okay, so you can go through that notes also. Now the genetic, what is the genetic consequences of protoplast fusion? So there is a result of symmetric hybrids, hybrid cells having the nuclear genome of both parent cells. This is the basic purpose. So just like solanum tuberosum and lycopersicum esculentum, so if we fuse these two, then there is solanum tuberosum and solanum brevidens, Nicotiana tobacum and Nicotiana repanda, Datura anoxis and Atropa belladonna. So these result in the formation of symmetric hybrids. Means what we need is a cell which have nucleus and cytoplasm from the both cells. We got it from here. Then there is a generation of asymmetric hybrids. In these, gradual elimination of chromosome of one of the parents. Here what happens, there is a gradual elimination of chromosome from one parent, and what we get, cytoplasm from both parents but nucleus from one parent. It is observed in Datura carota and also Oryza sativa. Then also it is found in Nicotiana tobacum and Datura carota. Okay, so this generally is asymmetric hybrid, okay, which is found. So cybrid is a different concept and we have already covered the cybrids, okay. Cybrid is nothing but a cytoplasmic hybrid or asymmetric hybrid which does have the cytoplasm from both parents with nuclei from the other parent. Thank you. Now, okay, so please do remember that this topic of protoplast fusion and somatic hybridization is over, and in next topic I will cover some different aspects just like somoclonal embryogenesis. Okay, please go through the video, and if you have any doubts feel free to call me. Okay, thank you very much.